I got a signal that we are live from Somerstown, Ontario, on the St. Lawrence Seaway, Somerstown, in between east of Ottawa, west of Montreal, kind of in between the two cities. So, yeah, another Sunday night. Another week's gone by, Labor Day weekend. So we're heading into another season in North America, in Canada. Summer goes by really quick in Canada. It seems to pass a little bit too quick. I'm always very busy in the summer, so don't really get to take part in a lot of summer activities, not like I used to. Back on the beach in Miguasha. So yeah, what are we doing tonight? Well, we got a few things tonight for you. I wanted to just start off by saying thank you for the support on Real Love. So there's been some really nice support, some really nice words. I appreciate all those comments that come. And there's some just comments that are descriptive, I guess, of how you feel about the song. And I like those, you know. Today I was talking to a few buddies of mine, and they were saying, you know, it's a positive thing. Likes to, you know, I move with the song, and that's kind of a part of what it was intended with this project. So, thank you so much for all the support and for everyone that's taken part in the YouTube subscription contest. We're gonna draw a winner tonight. So a $25 e-card, Amazon card, depending on where you are, but $25 e-card that you can use to buy whatever you can, whatever's out there. So we're gonna do that at the end of the show, I think, right? So and that's it. And with all of that, I just wanted to say a real special. I've said it before, but to April, who is just does most of the work with the social media and this show, and I get to get up here and talk and go blah 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 and sing some songs, but. A lot of behind-the-scenes stuff being done by April. So big shout out to my girlfriend and Mama, mother to Dylan. Dylan's doing good, by the way, everyone. He is not getting any smaller. He's getting bigger, and his cheeks are getting bigger, growing with him. But he's doing really good and. You know, he has his days, like all of us. But he's coming along nicely. A little over seven weeks old, so he'll be 8 weeks on Wednesday, and 2 months old on the 15th of this month. So so I'm gonna play a few songs here to get this started. I went to pick up Dylan last week, and the babysitter who watches the show sometimes gave me a little bit of, he said, you're talking too much and not playing enough music. So, yes, John, that was directed at you. I will play a little bit more songs. It's been a lot of promotion going on and a lot to do with Real Love and Real Love This and Real Love That and Real Love Acoustic and Real Love Here and... So I'm just gonna do some cover songs tonight and get back to just playing some music, you know. What do I'm looking at the board here. I think we're good to go. So I'm gonna bring on a guest, a friend of mine, who's had a huge part in this project, a huge part in the, and if you heard Real Love and you heard the studio version of that song, so you've heard his name before, Kevin Cook, who's been the brains behind this operation, the talent behind the board, and once in a while he'll get his fingers wrapped around a bass and do some cool stuff with that too. So Kevin Cook is going to join us a little bit later. We just want to have some fun. We're going to show you a little bit of us working together and ask Kevin a few questions about music in general and how music's changed and how specifically how recording has changed. So that's going to come in a little bit, but first, I'm going to play some songs, aren't I? I think I'm going to play a couple of songs. Wow. So I got my guitar and I got my headset on. So the headset so I can hear what's going on. It's not to look cool. It's so I can hear what's happening. And I'm going to start with a song, cover song by a guy by the name of Yusuf Islam. And if you don't know who Yusuf Islam is, you might know his former name, Cat Stevens. Cat Stevens wrote was a terrific writer, excellent guitar player. So I can't do the song quite like Yusuf Islam. Super talented, wrote many songs, and then kind of gave it up. Gave up his music career. He had found something else. He had found religion and spirituality, and he went to that world. But he does come out and play a lot of his songs now. He does live shows, and he's every time I've seen him on YouTube or something that he's done live lately, he's as talented now as he was then. So I'm going to do one of his more famous songs, and it's called Real Love. Nope, it's not called Real Love. Just wanted to bring that up again. It's called Wild World. So this is it. I'm going to try to get comfy and do a song for you here, and it's called Wild World. Let's play some music. Now that I've lost everything to you, you say you wanna start something new, and it's breaking my heart you're leaving. Well, baby, I'm grieving. But if you wanna leave, well, take good care. Hope you have a lot of nice things to wear. But then a lot of nice things turn bad out there. Do, baby, baby, it's a wild world. It's hard to get by just upon a smile. Do, baby, baby, it's a wild world. I'll always remember you like a child, girl. You know I've seen a lot of what the world can do, and it's breaking my heart in two. Cause I never wanna see a sad girl. But don't be a bad girl. But if you wanna leave, well, take good care. Hope you make a lot of nice friends out there. And just remember there's a lot of bad, and beware. Do, baby, baby, it's a wild world. It's hard to get by just upon a smile. Do, baby, baby, it's a wild world. I'll always remember you like a child, girl. Na 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 na. Oh, baby, I love you. And if you wanna leave, take good care. Hope you make a lot of nice friends out there. But just remember there's a lot of bad, and beware. Do, baby, baby, it's a wild world. It's hard to get by just upon a smile. Oh, baby, baby, it's a wild world. I'll always remember you like a child, girl. World. It's hard to get by just upon a smile. Don't, baby, baby, it's a wild world. I'll always remember you like a child, girl. Wild World. Yeah, that goes back some time. 70s maybe? Cat Stevens wrote that and a whole bunch of other great songs. So yeah, it's one of those things. I used to play it a long, long time ago a lot, and then stopped playing it, and started playing it again, I guess. It's always a little bit strange. Not strange, but it's... I've worked a lot with Kevin Cook. I think he's listening now. So vocally, we do a lot of work together, and we don't jam. Sort of, we're working, you know. So every time I know Kevin's listening, my voice, I'm a little bit more aware of my voice. But anyways, the voice is the voice. So that's it. That was Wild World. I'm gonna do one more, and then we're gonna bring Kevin Cook along for a few minutes and in a chat. We good for another song? So, have you ever heard of Neil Young? Yeah, and it was by accident that I pick a Neil Young song when Kevin's listening, so Kevin would know what that means. But so I'm gonna try a song by Neil Young. It's called Old Man. Neil Young is a Canadian. I think he's from Saskatchewan, maybe. He lives in L.A. I think he's been in L.A. for a long time and has a ranch here and there. And he's a very, very talented artist and one of the most famous Canadians alive. And he wrote a song called Old Man. And Old Man is about a ranch that he bought. And there was a keeper, you know, a ranch keeper, took care of the cattle, took care of the fences, and took care of the property. And I don't know what was in Neil Young's head, but he said this in concerts and interviews that the song "Old Man" was about the ranch keeper, who I don't know who that is, but it was about him, and turned out to be a pretty good song. So I'm going to give that one a shot. Old Man. No man, look at my life. I'm a lot like you were. Old man, look at my life. I'm a lot like you were. No man, look at my life. I need four and there's so much more. Live alone in a paradise that makes me think of two. Love lost such a cost. Give me things that don't get lost, like a coin that won't get tossed, rolling home to you. No man, look in my eyes, you can tell that's true. In my eyes, and you can tell that's true. look in your eyes, run around the same old town. Doesn't mean that much to me, I don't mean that much to you. And I've been first and last, look at how the time goes past. Well, I'm all alone at last, rolling home to you. No man, look at my life, I'm a lot like you. I need someone to love me the whole day through. Oh, one look in my eyes and you can tell that's true. No man, look at my life, I'm a lot like you were. Oh man, look at my life, I'm a lot like you were. Old man, so you're taught when you're playing live that if you make a mistake, you just got to roll through it. So if anyone knows the words of that song, they would have known I made a mistake in the chorus. But I rhymed the words because I said the same line three times. But that's okay. It's hard to take back. And I think it always sounds worse when you stop, you know, when you see an artist stop because they've made a mistake. I actually heard an interview with, who did we hear an interview with? Billie Eilish. On the Howard Stern show, Billie Eilish was talking about, yeah, many times that she's been and forgot the words and does, you know, do-do-do-do-do-do and tries to get through it. But, yeah, even the big stars, you know, they forget the words. Interesting. And tragically hip, Gord Downie, of course, at the last few years and especially on that last tour, if you know the Tragically Hip, and he was dying of brain cancer, and so his memory was one of the things that was lost, and he had prompters all over the stage, so that he could remember. He pretty much had to go word by word and line by line and read it. He could sing them. He remembered the tune. He remembered the song, and the words were just something that he needed to be prompted on. So, yeah, interesting. I wasn't planning on talking about that, but. But anyway, yeah, so that was Old Man by Mr. Neil Young, and he's done lots of songs. He's been in lots of bands. He's done lots of different styles. Later in his career, he really went to the electric and plowed away on that electric guitar. So that was that. So that's a couple of songs. That was two songs, right? So are we ready for our big guest, like I said, a friend of mine and a colleague in the studio and someone that's been responsible for this album in the hours and hours and hours that Mr. Kevin Cook has put into arranging. Having to listen to it and arrange them and mix and get these things out and make them sound you know, half decent like they were. And Kevin Cook has had to listen to my voice over and over and over again. I'm sure it must be a nightmare for him sometimes. He must have bad dreams about it. But are we ready for Kevin? We're going to bring Kevin Cook on for you. So he's not here with us, but he's here with us. Kevin's in Ottawa by remote. And Kevin, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
All right. Fine. Mr. Kevin Cook. So Kevin, thanks a lot for coming along, and we're just gonna have a chat about the project in general. So I think they've heard enough about my description of who you are and what you mean to this project. And there you are. I can see you, Kevin, on the screen. Looking cool. And so, Kevin.
Just playing along. Playing along with the track there.
Nice. Nice. Yeah.
Listen to you go at it there.
So did you, you heard the lyric mistake that I made?
I paid absolutely no attention, Bob. Sorry.
Nice. So Kevin's got his bass in his hand. He's a fabulous, bassist. He plays a lot of, jazz, fusion and, big band stuff and rock and roll and country and everything else that any kind of music you could possibly think of. He's probably been in a band that played it. So, Kevin, I wanted to ask you a question. Since you were since you've mixed and recorded and arranged this this whole project, 10 songs that we've done, and I thank you for putting
Is
up
it
with 10? Me.
It's, I've lost track.
It's 10 songs. We got 10 and a few more to finish up. Kevin, I wanted to ask you, and I really wanted to know, and I thought it'd be an interesting question. So you've been in the studios for the better part of most of your life, and you're a young man. We can all tell you're still a young man, but you've been...
Yeah.
You've been around the block. So what is a major difference about a recording project now as opposed to early 80s, 70s? What would be, you say, like a major difference?
It really depends where you want to start. Essentially, we have very, very flexible tools now. We can edit and manipulate things to extremes now. Back when recording first started, it was all about performance. So basically you had to play it. The musicians or group of performers had to actually do it. And in the very early days of recording, it was usually done with one microphone. So the position of the musicians and singers had to be manipulated in the space that they were recording in. And they got very good at it. There's some recordings from the early days where people really had their ears on. They understood how to get a good sonic picture. We go to the post-war era when magnetic tape shows up. And then we're starting to be able to do multi-tracks. In other words, record one thing and then play with that thing against the previous recording. That has just expanded to a ridiculous amount. Now we have access to any number of multi-tracks. And we have tools to manipulate sound. However, let's talk about our project. Because essentially our project is using a digital technology to record with, but that's all we're doing. We're playing off the floor. The parts are actually performed by people. And we're doing a lot of it together. So we're kind of recording how they used to record back before the big MIDI revolution in the 80s. Over to you, Bob.
Awesome. Okay. Well, I mean, the type of music that we're doing, I guess it's it would be difficult to do that in play that. I guess we could on MIDIs and drum loops and to do that, but that wouldn't be any fun. It's taken a lot of time. That's why it's taken a lot of time. But let's we're going to give you, you know what? I'm being prompted, Kevin, here to just do, are you able to do a little tour of that studio, that space? Or are
okay.
you afraid to move
so
your
this
phone?
So this is the Utility Muffin Research Outpost here. And I'm going to walk you around.
Awesome.
Okay. There's some of our hardware. This stack of equipment here, I hope you can see, because I can't, is virtually a history of recording. I actually have one of the Crown 800 mastering decks that was originally at Motown. It's a long story how that happened. Here's a DAT recorder. DAT was became a really useful and the common mastering method throughout the late 80s into the 90s. Here's an old cassette deck, but this is a really good cassette deck. This was the CBC standard one. These are preamps and things like that. I'll record with my gear. And here's our little space. And here's the actual, this is the GUI that we see, the interface we see when we're working down here. Okay, I'm going to put that up there. Can you see that?
Yeah, we can now. We're a little bit delayed on what I can see, but yeah, it's turning towards our DAW.
Okay. What I was going to do is, if you'd like to hear some of the original versions, this is the original bed track from the first time we recorded Real Love.
Let's see how that audio is.
Okay, let's just check that out, okay? Coming. So that's me, you, and Tommy here in the room. And we've made suggestions to each other. We've decided that we're going to carry over some of the things when we jam the tune. And that's the basic feel. We were doing more of a, for lack of a very old kind of Roxy Music disco feel.
Was that the original one that we did, or was that the one that ended up, because we did two different versions of that song. Was that the original?
No, we have three.
Oh, we have three. We've been
three. Yeah.
Wow. Eh?
This is from the original set of sessions.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's you using, you and I are going direct. We had your guitar, your acoustic guitar has internal pickups. We use that. And that's you, me, and Tommy.
That's so cool. We've been doing this a long time. So, Kevin, what I'm going to do now is we're just going to show people you and I working together on a vocal and then actually how that vocal turned out to be. So if you are out there and you're listening, then you can hear some real raw stuff and then what Kevin's able to do to push that out into to something that you can actually listen to. So are we ready for that, April? All right, this is Kevin and I working on a track called Tom Thompson, and it's one verse, and it's a little bit of Kevin suggesting and me doing a little bit. So here we go. Let's see this.
Okay. So it gives it a texture change. That'd be the only thing I could say. Other than that, that's okay.
Okay.
You want to try that again?
Sure.
Evening comes on with a gentle lull, and the daytime sounds begin to dull. The blue sky fades and the red sky falls on my eyes, it's magical. And the moon comes up like a lantern lit on the water's edge, the shadows shift. The mountains are now a silhouette, and a loon calls out from the mist.
That was raw footage and of us in the studio. I'm dancing around, and if you can see that, we're having fun. And then, can we actually play what this actually turned out to be, what it turned out, what Kevin turned this into?
Evening comes on with a gentle lull, and the daytime sounds begin to dull. Sky fades and the red sky falls on my mind, my eyes, it's magical. And the moon comes up like a lantern lit, and the water's edge, the shadows shift. The mountains are now a silhouette, and the loon calls out from the mist.
Wow, eh? Lucky that got into your hands, Kevin.
Well, I'd like to kudos to Dave Miller, who is playing keyboards on that.
Yeah, beautiful.
Did a nice job.
Percussions by Tommy and drums by Tommy and the bass by yourself.
Yep. an acoustic guitar by yourself. Yeah, that's all that's on there.
Yeah, it's a cool song. You'll hear it off the album when that comes out in a little while. But yeah, it's a song about Jack Pine, a painting by Tom Thompson. So you'll get to hear that in its totality in a little bit. So Kevin, I wanted to thank you very much for coming along, for joining us. We're going to be still working together. So we're going to be doing some other stuff. We're going to be, there's some really interesting stuff with Kevin and Tommy and conversations that we've been able to take video of. And so we're going to get some of that stuff out, because if you want to hear people that have been around and know music and have all kinds of stories about it, it's really fun for me to be in the studio sometimes, just that I turn my phone on and I'll listen to Kevin and Tommy going back and forth. And so, Kevin, I want to thank you so much for coming on, and we'll talk soon.
Okay. Bye, kids.
All right. That was Kevin Cook in all his glory. All right. Are we moving on to the raffle, or are we doing another song? All right, I am prompted. We're gonna do another song. So we're trying to make this work. We're experimenting, and I appreciate you all for anyone that's out there and joining us for a couple of minutes or joining us for the whole show. We're having fun with it. You know, it's just, this is about having fun too. It's about a Sunday night where April and I get together, and we have a babysitter for Dylan, and we get together, and we actually have a pretty cool setup. So it's fun to get doing this until we can get out there doing some stuff live. So I am going to do. Have you ever heard of a band? A band called the Beatles. I have April in front with the camera. So there was a band from Liverpool, England, and they were called the Beatles, and they did a song, early song, I think, right, that I just do sometimes. I'm going to dedicate this song to April, so it's kind of like one of my songs to her. She's not 17, but she's young. So how about we do some... of I Saw Her Standing There by the Beatles. Ready for this? She was just 17, and you know what I mean. And the way she looked was way beyond compare. How could I dance with another when I saw her standing there? And she looked at me, yeah, and I could see that before too long I'd fall in love with her. Well, she wouldn't dance with another. No, when I saw her standing there, my heart went boom when I crossed that room. I held her hand in mine. We danced through the night, and we held each other tight. And before too long, I fell in love with her. Now I'll never dance with another when I saw her standing there. Across that room, and I held her hand in my heart. We danced through the night, and we held each other tight. And before too long, I'd fall in love with her. And I'll never dance with another. No, I saw her standing there. When I saw her standing there. fun song. I don't quite do it like the Beatles. Do you guys know how good the Beatles were? I'm a big fan anyway. So, yeah, I saw her standing there. I think it's a McCartney song. Maybe it's a Lennon song. Or maybe it's both. I don't know. I saw Paul McCartney live in the Plains of Abraham in Quebec City with 300,000 people. Free concert. Spectacular. I've seen a lot of shows and I've never seen anything like that. So when Paul McCartney, he comes out and does one of the songs with a ukulele ukulele and in front of 300,000 people, and it was just mind-blowing. He's pretty talented. So we are going to do one more song here. And I got to get a different position for my leg, but it's too late now. I'm going to do a song that's called Thank You. Thank You. There's a lot of thank you songs out there. Different artists have recorded different thank yous. But to me, Thank You was the song recorded by the brilliant band Led Zeppelin. And it was just one of their softer songs. Led Zeppelin, what can you say? Did they steal a lot of blues stuff? Well, probably, but they played it pretty well. And they did a lot of very creative stuff on their own. I think Robert Plant's vocally, and Jimmy Page on guitar, and just some pretty talented guys in that band. So this is a song called Thank You, and we're gonna do this, and then we are going to get to the big raffle draw, because someone out there is going to win $25 e-card. And maybe you can buy some Real Love paraphernalia. Or some maybe one of my shirts with your new card. So remember that. You can buy Bobby Parent t-shirts with your $25 e-card, or you can just do whatever you want with it, too. That's up to you. So here we go with Thank You by Led Zeppelin. If the sun refused to shine, I would still be loving you. When mountains crumble to the sea, there would still be you and me. Kind woman, I'll give you my all. Kind woman, nothing more. Little drops of rain, whisper of the pain, tears of love lost in the days gone by. And my love is strong, and here there is no wrong. Together we shall go until we die. Well, my. An inspiration's what you are to me. Inspiration, look, see. So today, my world, it smiles. Your hand in mine, will we walk the miles? And thanks to you, well, it will be done. For you to me are the only one. happiness will no more be sad. Happiness, well, I am glad. And if the sun refused to shine, well, I would still be your loving you. Yes, and mountains crumble to the sea, and there would still be you and me. Inspiration's what you are to me. Inspiration, look, see. Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you, April. Thank you, everyone. Thank you is a nice expression, isn't it? Thank you. You know, when you say thank you to someone, it actually makes you feel better. Have you noticed that? You know, unless they've kicked you in the head or something like that, and then saying thank you is that's me trying to be funny. So I've got someone dancing to the left or to the right of you. Yeah, Led Zeppelin, thank you. So I've got, we're going to do the raffle draw. This has been a lot of fun. This has been April's idea. And she's had a lot of fun with it. And it's just been a lot of fun getting the comments and getting the little pictures of subscribing in YouTube. And April is a lot of fun in general. So she loves to laugh and loves to just have fun with things. It's just been a lot of fun. She has to drag me along sometimes. There's a video on YouTube of us actually trying to record something where I'm impatient and a little cranky and grouchy, and she's just laughing and keeping it going. So, what are we gonna do here, April? I pick a name. So I'm going to pick a name out of a fishbowl. She's trying to make sure that it's fair. Joanne, if you win this, I'm telling you, we're going to do another draw, Joanne. So what do? I open this up? I don't have my glasses, so I can't see. I'll need my glasses for this. She doesn't like me to wear my glasses, but... oh, here, I'm going to get my glasses for this. This is the big, what do you call when they're... when you're waiting for the winner, you know, on those contests. So this is me with my glasses. I'm pretty much the same person. I just got glasses on, and I can see, and that's what glasses are for. So what do we have here? There's a bit of suspense, and the winner is. And I don't know if I can pronounce this name right, but the winner of this one, the winner is Neil Tankis Bargo. Neil Tanqui Bargo. Neil, I'm sorry if you're out there or if you hear this later that I'm probably butchering your name, but Neil Bargo, that sounds just about right. So, Neil, you've just won a $25 e-card. This is it here, April. And the winner is Neil Bargo. That's a cool name, Neil Bargo. Neil, I wish I knew how to... Neil Tanqui. Neil, you'll have to... send me a little voice thing of how you pronounce that name. Anyways, Neil, enjoy your $25, and thank you for subscribing, and thank you to everyone who subscribed to the YouTube channel. We're building on our social media channels, and that's what we're doing. And we do apologize. I know there's a lot of stuff that goes out, and some of you hear it, see it over and over and over again, but. It's part of the game. It's part of the promo that we do. There's a lot of people that's worked really hard in this project, so I feel it very necessary to promote it as much as I can for people like Kevin Cook and Tommy and other people who've worked really hard. So I'm supposed to read something in red. Lady in red. Lady in... raffle draw. Do I read that? She points, but you can talk, April. What is only the people? Yeah. Only the people who sent. Oh, so this was the draw. We just want to qualify. It was only for the people who actually sent in the screenshot. So I think that was the contest. I don't know a lot about the contest. I'll be honest with you. Yeah, only the ones who actually sent the screenshot of the actual subscription. To those who did that, and to those who participated in this, and to those who didn't, who just subscribed, and to those who follow me on Facebook, and to those who listened to my song, and to those who have watched these shows, I thank you very, very much. It's really all about that. We really want to build something into... something to have fun. This project of mine, for me, it was about hope, and I want to bring that hope. I want to bring that energy. I want to bring something positive and give something back, because the world gave me something and showed me something and showed me a way that I didn't know before. And this part of this music is about music, and part of it, you know, just playing. And I'm a musician and an artist, but it's the whole of the project is also about hope, that there's always hope. There's hope out there when you don't think there is hope. When you think it's you're down and out. There's always hope. There's 'cause people are there, and people are a lot. Are more giving and forgiving and than I ever thought. So much gratitude, very grateful, and that's what we're trying to do here. We're trying to give back, and of course promote Real Love, because it says right on the screen, promote Real Love. So you can get that in Spotify and Amazon and all kinds of different places. You can see the you can hear the official audio on YouTube. I think we have a lyric video coming out. I don't know how it works. Like, it's Spotify. You can buy it on Spotify and Amazon, but you can go also just for free on my YouTube page too, and you can listen to it that way. So, we're doing good. So I promoted the YouTube channel. I promoted Real Love. I've done what my producers asked me, I think. She's awesome. By the way, we're going to bring her on. We're going to bring her on soon. She just got a little bit of the mumminess in her that I'm not going to explain what that means. Just if your mama's out there, you'll know. But soon she's going to want to come out and she's going to sing some songs. And we're going to have fun. We want you to have fun, and we want you to have a great week. And enjoy your holiday Monday if you're in North America. Enjoy some time with your family, some time relaxing, and... That's it. Happy Labor Day weekend for North Americans. And I don't know what's going on in Australia and New Zealand, but happy Monday. And let's take it one day at a time. Let's take it one breath at a time. And we're going to come back next Sunday. So thank you, Kevin Cook, for coming on again. And thank you for everything you've done. And that's it. Can I say over and out? Peace and love. Peace out. Have a great week. Thanks.